When it comes to this, I mean, for example, talking about the children and how smoking can harm them, for example, the place outdoors, because smoking inside is not allowed. So I can smell it very well, even though we are outdoors, and you know, but sometimes I feel that the air is polluted. I smell the smoking, let's say 2 meters. So of course this will affect me, for example, or that's why the air is, can it pollute the air, for example?
Yeah, that's a very good observation.
It happened to me a lot.
Actually, in some cities or in some buildings, they designate a room for smoking. But this is also totally not accepted. There is no, you know, the Americans say about designating rooms in a building just for smokers is that if you are in a swimming pool, there is no, you cannot draw a line and say this is a peeing area and this is a non-peeing area. you cannot stop smoke from going into the other rooms. There is no safe level.
But you are talking about a room. I'm talking about outdoors, in the air. Just because now we have a lot of such companies that are located, they can move out of the company, for example, and move out to the street, and they stand and they smoke.
Yeah, I mean, this is the least you can do to...
But still, he can affect all the people that people who will pass by.
Of course.
They didn't do anything except they are walking in the streets.
Of course, you know, if you know that smoke has at least 2,000 chemicals, 50 of them are carcinogenic. DDT, which is an internationally banned pesticide, is in the smoke, is in the cigarette smoke. Cyanide, carbon monoxide, lead, 50 carcinogens are there in the smoke. And you know, just by inhaling the smoke, you can get affected.
Could you give us some information about how smoking is linked to cancer and how it could lead to an escalation of cancer in our bodies?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Smoking, as I just mentioned, there are 2,000 chemicals in the smoke, in the cigarette smoke. 50 of them can cause cancer. Like, as I said, there is cyanide, carbon monoxide, DDT, lead, I mean, a lot of chemicals that can, benzene, butane, all this can cause cancer. So, talking about cancer, what cancers can we get from smoking? You have nasal sinuses cancer. You have lips, mouth, oral cavity, larynx, laryngeal cancer. Lung cancer is on the top of the list, lung cancer. Cervical cancer in females. Some forms of leukemias, esophageal cancer, colon cancer, pancreatic cancer. So, I mean, it's...
scary.
It is scary. Smoking is linked...
You know what is the most, or the strange thing about it is that it's one of the main sources of our income here in Egypt.
You know, it's, I'm
and
very
so
happy
far, even that whatever happened after the revolution, still the only source of income that is really working is smoking.
It's no, I, you know, I cannot say it's the
or
only,
the factory of
it's
smoking
the only
or
source
something
of income.
Like, no,
because,
it is one
know,
of the main sources. It was announced that...
It is a source of income,
but...
Of course, the Suez Canal is the number one source of income.
No, I'm not talking in relation to the Suez Canal or the tourism. I'm talking about industries, about factories, yes, industries working.
Yeah. I'll answer that very important.
But very quickly, because we only have less than a minute.
Yeah, okay. The tobacco industry tries to propagate that. Oh, it's an important industry, you cannot close it down. But this is not very true. I mean, you pay a few billion dollars in Egypt every year as a cost of loss of productive years, sickness, treatments, absenteeism, fires. There is an economic cost for that, which is a few billion dollars every year. The world spends $500 billion a year as a cost for smoking. So if you know that, if you know that the general domestic product of Egypt, the GDP, loses nearly 4% of its value because of smoking, then you know.
We opened something that we have to talk about it a lot, actually, because even though citizens will pay for this, but again, the amount of money will come from the factory or from this industry to the country itself. You know, it's a long story. Let's discuss it in another episode.
It's true, but I am sure that the income coming from the tobacco industry is much less than 4% of the GDP of Egypt.
At the end, Dr. Mohammad Shahlan, Professor of Surgery, National Cancer Institute, thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you.